All right, is that, hurry up, come and have a seat, please. We're about to get started. We're running late. Man, have a seat. All right, before we get started, if I could have your attention. Yesterday, there was a little bit too much talking going on in the courtroom today. I've instructed the judge in here that if it continues today, she is to have the responsible people removed. And I will talk to your teacher about lowering the citizenship rate. So if you don't want to listen and take part in the trial, all you have to do is tell me and I'll send you back to class. And otherwise, I expect you to be courteous and pay attention.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen of the court. This is case number 1847, People v. Ballard. Ms. Ballard is being charged with hit and run under California Vehicle Code 2001 and 2003. This is the third day of the trial.
Please rise. Raise your right hand or repeat after me. I swear to do my best. As a jury member for this trial.
As a jury member for this trial.
Listen carefully.
So listen carefully.
To the statements and evidence presented.
To the statements and evidence presented.
Make my decision.
Make my decision.
Based on the evidence presented.
Based on the evidence presented.
Yesterday we left off with Ralph Lombardi, and now defense was cross-examining him.
You swear to tell the truth, all the truth, nothing but the truth, so you got to make it good. Please state your full name and spell your last name.
Ralph Gabardi, G-A-B-A-R-D-I.
Can I approach the witness?
Yes, sir.
Can you please instruct the witness to answer all my questions with a yes or no answer?
Please answer counsel's questions with a yes or no.
Mr. Gabardi, were you at Jill Cochran's party on the night of April 27, 1984?
Yes.
You weren't at Jill Cochran's party?
April 27.
And you met Miss Cindy Ballard at this party?
Yes.
And were you attracted to Miss Cindy Ballard? No, you weren't attracted to Miss Cindy Ballard. But you did go out to Miss Cindy Ballard's car, isn't that true?
Yes.
Yes. And do you often go out to young ladies' cars who you really aren't attracted to?
No.
No.
Yes or no answers, please. And you testified already in direct that you have a girlfriend in Switzerland. And you still went out to the car with Miss Cindy Ballard to talk.
Yes.
Do you frankly, do you admit getting into Miss Ballard's car?
Yes.
And did you both slam doors separately?
Yes.
Did you notice that it was raining that night?
It was misty. Yes.
And when Officer Martinez came to your house, did you tell him that it was raining that night? And that was the reason that your clothes were wet?
Yes.
What was it?
Objection on compound question.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard the last question.
She can ask. That means that there's two questions being asked at the same time. If she can rephrase it, you should allow her to do that.
Okay. Could you please rephrase the last question? When Officer Martinez came to your house, did you tell him that your clothes are wet?
Yes. I showed him.
And you told him that your clothes are wet because of walking home that night?
Yes.
Had it been raining all the time that you had walked home that night?
No.
Was it raining when you walked home that night?
It was misty.
It was misty.
Yes.
Can I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may. 10-second recess.
Order in court. So you said it was misting when you walked out, that's true?
Yes.
So how could your clothes get so wet just from it misting?
It was misting.
Yes, sir. Did your clothes get wet just from the mist?
Yes.
And can you tell me about where your house is from Miss Jill Cochran's house?
Miss Cochran's house is right here. My house is here, and I live in the apartment right now.
Would you say that it's about 1 mile?
Approximately, yes.
If you were to be driving, which way would you leave Jill Cochran's house to go to your house?
Sure. I'm not really familiar with
it. Your Honor, she asked for yes or no questions.
But I'm not asking him to answer a question. I'm asking him to show.
You should instruct the judge that in this question he can say something.
Your Honor, can you instruct the witness that he can show on the map where he wrote?
Barty, in this question, you may show on the map where you drew it.
Okay. I'm not really familiar, but if I had driven, I probably would have taken this road right there.
So you would have crossed the crosswalk where Miss LaFrance was hit?
If I had driven.
Wouldn't you say it would have been more comfortable to ride in a car instead of walking in the rain?
Under the circumstances.
Yes or no?
Excuse me, objection, Your Honor. She didn't re-instruct the witness to answer yes or no.
Oh, my God. Sandra, please disregard the last question.
Can you ask that? Wouldn't it be more comfortable to get a ride in the car home instead of walking in the rain?
No.
No. So you'd rather walk home in the rain and get wet?
Yes. You were sure, yes.
Yes or no?
Order in the court.
You were wearing a black jacket that night, isn't that correct?
Yes.
And you do have dark hair, correct? So that would make it sort of hard to see you at night, correct? So if you would have been in Miss Cindy Ballard's car, it might not have been as noticeable to see you, since she was wearing white and you were wearing dark clothes, correct?
No.
So you would have stood out in your black clothes? You must be very fortunate to be a guest in this country, correct?
Yes.
And to be a medical student?
Yes.
And to be charged of a crime like this that would probably ruin your chances to be in this country?
Objection on a false for opinion.
He already answered.
Sustained jury, please disregard the last question.
And another objection. She's harassing our witness also.
Oh. Oh, God. Mm-hmm. Yes, council members.
Would you protect yourself to stay in this country? You're a pretty caring person, you say. So, telling us to believe that you are a caring person, that you are left an intoxicated Miss Ballard to drive herself home?
No.
So you would have drove her home? But just a second ago, you said you would not leave an intoxicated person if she asked you to drive her home, and you stated no. And now you say that you wouldn't drive her?
She didn't ask me to drive her home.
Isn't it true that a sick Miss Gabardi asked you to drive her home?
Excuse me?
Did Miss Ballard ask you to drive her home?
No.
No. Is it true that you had been drinking straight out of a vodka bottle that night?
Objection, you already stated earlier that you did not. Stay in jury,
please disregard the last question.
What time did you... Can you instruct the witness to answer this question without a yes or no? What time did you arrive home?
It must have been approximately 11:30, since I heard Jenny Carson's monologue.
So you would have been able to walk home, and it would probably take you about 5 minutes to change out of your clothes dry off, get dressed, and still make the beginning of the Johnny Carson show?
Objection, Your Honor. He already stated that he had heard the Johnny Carson show, not saw it.
Governor Rule, you may ask a question.
I did hear it as I was hanging my clothes.
And, but, so you arrived in your house at what time would you say?
About 11:30.
11:30. But it would have been starting at 11:30. You would have been in the bathroom hanging up your clothes and all that time. All in 11:30, you could have done all that?
No, what I did was I went home, turned on the TV set, went to take my clothes off and put them in the shower. And as I was in the shower, I was in the then I went up to watch.
Can I have a 10-second recess?
Yes, you may. 10-second recess.
Okay. You guys don't beat it to death, okay? You're going to get the jury upset if you just get through next useless questions. So, finish up. Ask the question.
Can we ask him? He said that he didn't want to wait downstairs and help him and listen to Johnny Carson while he was still in the bathroom.
Well, if you think it's important, but don't get a bunch of non-necessary facts.
Order in the court. I have one further question. Were you in the Ballard automobile the night of April 27, 1984? No further questions. Prosecution, do you have any more witnesses who would like to call this down?
No, we don't, Your Honor.
Defense, are you
going to
call your first witness?
Yes, I am, Your Honor. I would like to call Ms. Narasaki to the stand. Your Honor, may I pledge witness?
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning, Ms. Narasaki. How are you doing?
I'm fine, but I'm real upset.
How are you doing?
Yeah,
it's okay. I'm
going
to have no matter. State your name and occupation for the court.
My name is Ms. Narasaki. I'm a student associate for Ballard High School.
Do you know Ms. Cindy Ballard?
Yes, I do.
How well do you
know? Excuse me, just for a moment. Can I move the microphone? Hello.
Let me repeat your question. How well do you know her?
Ever since she's been on the swing team.
Will you point out Ms. Cindy Ballard for the court, please?
Yeah, she's wearing the white striped outfit over there.
Is Ms. Cindy Ballard your swimmer?
Yeah, she's one of my best swimmers that I ever had.
Do you see your swimming career advancing?
Yes.
In what direction?
Objection, Your Honor. It's relevant to the case. Overall, you may ask your last question.
She has received a scholarship to our swimming team, and she's made her chances of making the 1988 Olympics is very excellent.
This is a very important question, Mrs. Narasaki. Would you lie for Ms. Cindy Ballard?
No, I would not.
Other than being a good swimmer, what do you believe Ms. Cindy Ballard's qualities are?
Her concern for others. She often stops her routines to care for other people that are hurt or injured.
In your opinion, do you think Ms. Ballard would have even seen the crime if someone was hurt or injured?
No, I certainly would not.
Thank you, Your Honor. No further questions.
Judges, I don't know, you'd be pleased if she would lie for her, like, in a different way, and then just a real question, do you know what I mean? I put that into, I hope Baker should say, isn't it true? Say, would you do anything for the world? You could say, would you lie for her? You can say, would you do anything for the world? You know, you should do something like that.
Order in court. Prosecution, are you ready to cross-examine the witness?
Yes, I am. I'm a senior. You're a lawyer, if you check the witness, as you're asking.
You must speak way up. I'm sorry, I got a little voice. Speak up loud.
Please answer the counsel's question with a yes or no answer.
You said that Mrs. Ballard had an opportunity to swim in the U.S. Olympics. Is that correct?
Yes.
That she's an excellent swimmer. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Well, with Cindy, Ms. Ballard, making the U.S. Olympic team, would that reflect upon you? I mean, would that give you any glory as being the coach of a U.S.
Objection, Your Honor.
An opinion.
Overruled, you may answer the question.
That would reflect glory upon you as being the coach of an Olympic swimmer. Is that correct?
Yes.
So you would like to see Ms. Ballard get out of this trial being unharmed so that she could pursue her career. Is that correct? Okay. And Mrs. Narasaki, you said that you trust Ms. Ballard. Is that correct?
Yes.
Have you ever witnessed Ms. Ballard being under the influence of alcohol?
No.
So you would not know how she would act, or even if you would trust Ms. Ballard while under the influence. Is that correct?
Objection, Your Honor. She has no knowledge of Cindy Ballard under the influence of alcohol.
It's irrelevant to the case.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard the last question.
Did you see Ms. Ballard on the night of the accident before you bailed her out of jail?
No, I haven't.
So you really have no idea of the conditions that went on 22nd at the Boulevard on that night, do you?
Objection. She still has no knowledge.
Overruled. You may answer the question.
No, I don't.
So, Mrs. Narasaki, did you see the accident occur?
No.
So, basically what you're doing here today is just trying to build the character of Mrs. Ballard. Is that correct?
No.
But you stated that you did not see the accident occur. Is that correct?
No, I didn't. But I do know when she was home.
Actually, she said the answer yes or no to her questions. Because, I mean, no, because what? Why is she going
to... Counselor.
Your testimony here is to build the character of Mrs. Ballard, correct? And you did not see the accident occur, is that correct?
Yes.
Compound question, Your Honor.
I got
just saying, jury, please disregard the last question. You may rephrase the question.
Did you see the accident on 5th Hill and 22nd Street occur?
Objection, Your Honor. She already asked that question.
Say, please, to drive the last question.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Do you think I'm ready to call the next witness?
Yes, I am, Your Honor. I'd like to call Mr. Barry Porter to the stand.
Order in the court.
Ralph and Cindy talking at the party. What happened next, Mr. Porter?
They went into the ring. They walked out the kitchen back door.
After you seen him leave the house through the kitchen door and the two car door slam, what did you do next?
Watch the music videos and watch MTV and I went into the bathroom.
What were you doing in the upstairs bathroom?
He was in the bathroom.
And what did you do the next thing for?
Yeah, I looked out the window on the curiosity.
Did you see anyone get out?
No, Your Honor, you expect witness to speak up and can't see the bathroom.
Last question. Okay. What did you next, Mr. Porter?
I looked out the window out of curiosity and I saw someone in the car.
Okay. Did you see anyone get out of the car before I pulled away?
No.
Since you and Cindy are good friends, would you lie for missing the ball in court?
Of course not.
10 second recess, Your Honor.
1984, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And it said, if Miss Jill Cochran introduced Miss Ballard and Mr. Gabbardi upon his arrival, is it possible to have seen Ralph Gabbardi drink straight out of a vodka bottle? are you for certain that it was a vodka bottle?
Yes.
Were you close enough to have seen him drinking?
Pretty much, yeah.
So you're watching him awfully close?
Not necessarily. Well, no.
No? But you were for certain that it was a vodka bottle?
Yes.
Okay, you said that you saw them dance, right? You saw them dance, and then you saw them leave the kitchen, correct? To go out to the car?
Yes.
Okay. But you also said that you were upstairs watching some music videos, you know, playing around with guys. Correct? You're watching music videos, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So, the music videos average about 4 minutes, correct?
Some.
Okay, and if you were watching music videos, and Mr. Gabbardi and Miss Ballard, they were out there for about 10 to 15 minutes before he left, and you went to the bathroom after, isn't it possible that you missed Mr. Gabbardi leaving Miss Ballard's car?
No.
No, you're for certain that you saw them leave in the car?
Yes.
You're for certain? Okay, well, in the bathroom, do you have a very clear view of the car?
Objection.
The
objection, he said there was a window in the bathroom that he could have saw.
What was that?
You answer the question.
You may answer the question.
Okay, since you're for certain that they were out in the car and drove away.
Objection, Your Honor. Harassing the witness.
Thank you.
something.
Can you just speak up, please?
I'm speaking up. You don't need the mic, you might have to speak up, Della.
Yes.
Don't be rude now.
Yes, no.
Sing a song.
Yes.
Sing a song.
We have to go with that, of course.
Okay, Mr. Porter, you watched Miss Ballard and Awful at the party. You said you were talking, and then you saw them exit, correct?
Yes.
Well, why is it that you were watching her so... Oh, sorry, that's not yes or no. Your Honor, would you please ask the witness to answer accordingly?
You may ask her the question accordingly.
Okay, why is it that you were watching Miss Ballard so much? You saw her dance with him, you saw him leave, and then up in the bathroom you happened to look out and see them in the car. Or you saw the car.
First, I never said I saw them dance together. I said I saw him leave, but I never said I saw them dance together. And I watched them because I was concerned.
You did. I asked you a couple questions ago if you saw them dance, and you said yes, you did.
I said yes to the bottle.
Please speak up.
Yeah. Isn't it possible that you might have more than a friendly interest in Miss Ballard?
Objection, Your Honor. Stay that, Miss Direct.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard the last question.
Okay, Mr. Porter, from your viewpoint from the bathroom window, could you see who was in the car? Wait, Your Honor, would you please re-instruct the witness to answer yes or no to my questions?
Please answer yes or no to all counsel's questions.
Okay. Is it possible that you might have missed Mr. Gabardi exiting the car and walking down the street?
Could you please ask the witness to speak up, please?
Witness, would you please speak up?
Okay. You saw for certain you cannot say positiveness that you saw Mr. Gabardi driving Miss Ballard's car. Is that correct?
No. I couldn't say for certain. No.
You couldn't say for certain that Mr. Gabardi was driving Miss Ballard's car. Could you see from your vantage point who was driving the car?
No.
What other question?
Joe Cochran at the stand. Raise your right hand. You swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So if you got it.
Yes, I do.
Okay, can you understand? Please state your full name and let's go.
Joe Cochran, C-O-C-H-R-I-N.
Want to put the witness on?
Yes, you may.
Good morning, Ms. Cochran. How you doing?
Fine.
Okay, Ms. Cochran, I want you to relax and be as calm as you can, okay? Are you Miss St. Bob's closest friend?
Yes, I am.
Okay, let's think back to the night of April 27, 1984. Did you host a build-a party for Miss Bob?
Yes, I did.
What kind of drinks did you have there?
I just served punch and soda.
Okay. Did you introduce Ralph to Cindy?
Yes, I did.
Did you see Ralph and Cindy leaving the party?
Yes, I did.
Where did they exit in the house?
They left through the kitchen door.
Do you know why they went outside?
As far as I know, I thought they were going to talk. And
Would you please tell the jury and the court
why they went
outside to talk?
I think Cindy was going to ask.
Objection, Your Honor. Cosper,
overruled. You may ask a question.
As as far as I know, they were going outside to talk because Cindy was, she had a couple of drinks. She was going to ask Ralph to drive her home.
Objection, Your Honor. They went outside to talk.
She already answered the question.
Okay, Mrs. Cochran, what was Miss Cindy Ball wearing that night?
She was wearing a white sweatshirt that was stood out pretty well.
Could you see what she was wearing outside in the dark?
Yes.
What was Ralph wearing that night?
He was wearing a dark members only jacket and jeans.
Could you see him in the dark?
Not really, because the dark members only jacket.
Did you see them getting into the car?
No.
Are you familiar with your car?
Pretty much so, yes.
Did you see it leaving the driveway?
No.
Did you see Miss Sandy in the car?
Yes, I did.
Where was she sitting?
From my angle, it seemed she was sitting in the middle of the front seat.
Okay. You clearly stated that you and Miss Ballard are best friends.
Mm-hmm.
My question is, did you like Miss Sandy Ballard in court?
No, I wouldn't.
Thank you, Lonnie. Thank you.
This is irrelevant to the case. It has nothing to do with drinking. That's a duty of felony, Your Honor.
Do you realize that you are under legal drinking age?
Yes.
Okay, as hostess of this party, you said you did not supply alcohol, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, were you aware of its presence?
Yes.
Okay. Did you at any time ask them to remove the alcohol from your house?
No, I didn't.
Your Honor, you might ask this witness. Would you ask this witness? Why did you not ask them to remove your premises?
Because I felt Cindy, well, it was for her, the party was for Cindy. I felt she could have a couple drinks to relax. She's been under a lot of stress lately from swimming, and she could give her a little time to relax and just, you know.
Chill.
Do you realize that that's illegal?
Yes, I do.
So you're saying that you knew that you broke the law?
Yes.
Objection, Your Honor. She said that she did not serve the alcohol, so she was not breaking the law.
Exactly. I didn't ask them to repeat the question, please.
I said, did you ask them to take the alcohol out of your house?
No, I didn't.
Do you know that you were breaking the law?
Yes.
Okay. So basically what you did was apply a place for minors to drink illegally, correct?
Say that?
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Ms. Cochran, isn't that a fact that Ms. Ballard got drunk while attending a party at your home?
No.
You're saying that Ms. Ballard was not drunk at her home. She did not get drunk.
Objection, Your Honor. She has no knowledge of what it can be for her to be drunk.
She's not that
she only had a few drinks. She cannot. She doesn't have knowledge of what it is for Miss Ballard to be drunk.
Okay, stand jury, please disregard the last question.
Are you clear seeing that you rather enjoyed Simi's being drunk because she was always so serious, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Well, didn't that right there say that you enjoyed her being drunk? She did get drunk when she was at your party drunk in her house, correct?
No.
You're completely contradicting yourself. You said you enjoyed her being
drunk. Just harassing the witness.
Stay. Please rephrase the question.
Rephrase. Okay. I quote from your statement that you enjoyed Simi's being drunk, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now, Now, just a second ago, you said that Miss Ballard was not drunk at your home. Isn't that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you know what Miss Ballard had to drink tonight at the party?
Yes.
Your Honor, would you please ask the witness to answer accordingly?
Please answer all questions accordingly.
What was it Miss Ballard had to drink tonight at the party?
Some wine and a couple, some mixed drinks.
Could you please check your answer, yes or no?
Please answer with a yes or no to all of questions.
Thank you very much. Ms. Cochran, isn't it true that you introduced Ms. Ballard and Mr. Flaherty upon his arrival?
Yes, it is.
Then was it possible to have him drink anything before leaving to talk with Ms. Ballard?
Yes.
It is possible?
Yes.
Did you witness him drinking?
No, I did not.
Okay. You said you could see Miss Ballard in the car from the kitchen, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any trees or anything around your house?
No.
No? Okay, so then there was nothing obstructing your view, correct?
Not really.
Okay. When you saw Miss Ballard in the middle of the seat, is it possible that that's when she was making a pass to Mr. Gabbardi and moved toward them?
No.
No, it's not possible in any way.
Objection, Your Honor. She's putting words into her mouth.
Okay, jury, please disregard the last question.
Did you see him leave?
Yes. No.
Yes. You did not see them leave.
Objection, the question is too vague.
Change, you may like to rephrase that question.
When you saw or heard the car, Miss Ballard's car, pull out of the driveway. Did you see who was driving?
No, I didn't.
Objection, Your Honor, compound.
No, I didn't.
So you cannot say with certainty that Mr. Gabbardi was driving?
No, I can't.
Okay, you may be seated. Defense,
are
you ready to call
the
witness?
Yes, Your Honor, I'd like to call up Miss Cindy Ballard.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, the truth, nothing but the truth, so can God? Please state your full name and spell your last name.
My name is Cindy Ballard, Ballard.
May I report to witness, Your Honor?
Yes, Your Honor.
Hi, Miss Ballard. How are you doing?
All right.
Miss Ballard, I'm going to ask you a series of questions. In answering, could you please speak loudly and clearly so that the jury members can hear you?
Yes.
And also, if you'd like to elaborate on your questions and answers, thank you so much. Are you Joe Cochran's best friend?
Yes, I am.
Will you show the jury members where Miss Cochran's house is on the map?
Right here on Skyline Drive.
Yeah. Will you show jury members where your house is?
My house is here on Meadow Valley Road.
Do you go over to Mrs. Cochran's house a lot?
Yes, I do.
Which route do you take when you go there?
Well, the fastest way is here. I go back around behind Miss LaFrance's house, behind Miss Franklin's house, all the way down to Skyline Drive.
Do you always take this route when you go to Miss Cochran's house,
every
no matter what time
of
day
time
it is?
Too.
Why do you take this route?
It's the fastest way.
Where did you go on the night of April 27, 1984?
To my friend Joe Cochran's house.
Did you drive there?
Yes, I did.
What was the weather like that night?
It was raining.
What were you wearing that night?
I was wearing my white bellwether sweatshirt and my jeans.
Did you talk to anyone at the party?
Uh-huh.
Who did you talk to?
I talked to my friend Barry Porter.
What did you mostly talk about at the party?
We talked about upcoming swimming events.
Did you meet anyone at the party?
Yes, I did.
Who did you meet?
Mr. Ralph Gambardi.
Will you point out Mr. Ralph Gambardi for the court, please?
He's right there in the black, gray, and white shirt.
Was this the first time you met him?
Yes, it was.
What was he wearing that night?
He's wearing a dark members-only jacket and his jeans.
Did you talk to him at the party?
Yes, I did.
Was it still raining out when you went outside?
Yes, it was.
So where did you go then?
We went into my car so we wouldn't get wet.
When you got into the car, where were you sitting?
I was sitting in the middle, in the front seat.
Where was he sitting?
In the driver's seat.
What did you talk about in the car?
We talked about almost about him all the time. We talked about why he came down here, how it was, you know, in Switzerland. And that was the reason why he came down here, because he didn't like it there.
How did you feel that night?
I felt pretty sick.
Did you drive home?
No, I didn't.
Who drove you home?
Mr. Gambardi.
Why did you drive you home?
Because I asked him to.
Did you refuse?
No.
Were you relieved to have someone drive you home?
Yeah.
Did you give him directions on how to get to your house?
Yes, I did.
Did he follow them?
Nope.
Did you say anything to him?
Yes.
Why?
Well, I told him the way I go home because it's the only way that I really knew. But he decided to go his own way, so I just thought, you know, he knew where to go, and that's the way he was familiar with.
How was Ron driving that night?
Pretty fast.
How fast would you say?
The speed limit in a residential area is about 25 miles per hour. Approximately about 45 to 50 miles per hour.
Did you tell him to slow down?
Several times.
Did he do it?
No.
What happened next?
All I know is that I put my head back because I was feeling pretty sick. And right when I looked up, we hit this image in a green jogging suit. And I just saw her fly, and I just screamed so loud.
Did you tell him to stop?
Yeah, I screamed. And I was like, when I screamed, I was like, you know, stop, I'm panicked. He stopped when we hit her, and then he looked, and then he just sped off.
What happened next?
He asked me how to get to my house, and I just kept telling him to go back, go back. And he just went, go back. And he just went. He knew where I lived.
He did?
Yep.
Has he ever been at your house before?
Not when I was home.
Okay. Where did he park the car?
He parked it like half on my driveway and half on the grass.
Did he say anything to you?
Yeah, he was panicked too. He kept yelling, saying, please, don't tell nobody. Don't tell nobody that I drove you home. And, you know, I just kept asking why. You know, we hit a person. You know, go back. He wouldn't go back. He said, no way. If I went back, they'd deport me back to Switzerland. I wouldn't be able to become a medical doctor. I don't want to go back home. He's really scared about going back home.
Okay.
Counsel, you'll have to continue your questioning tomorrow. Order in court. This court will adjourn until tomorrow morning, Friday, January 26th at 10:15. I will again remind you, the jury, not to read the newspapers, watch the news, or discuss the case with anyone, especially anyone assembled in this court today.
My class stays here till the bell rings. January 1990, Court of Kearney High School, the Honorable Judge Gomez now resides.
You were supposed to say that.
You may be seated.
Swear to jury.
Remember, we go last.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen of the court. This is case number 1847. Ms. Ballard is being charged with hit and run under California Vehicle Code 2001 and 2003. This is the third day of the trial.
Fourth day of trial.
Fourth day of the trial.
right hand. Do you swear to tell the whole truth, nothing but the truth, self again? No. Do the best of your knowledge to listen to all of the evidence presented here and to do the best of your job and knowledge, etc., that you're going to give the right.
Yesterday we left off with Cindy Ballard, and now defense will continue to examine him.
Get this word back in.
Two stars up, I'm waiting.
Sit down, spell your name.
And state your full name and spell your last name. No, you say that.
Would you state your full name, please, and spell your last name?
Cindy Ballard, B-A-L-L-A-R-D.
Thank you.
To the case.
Overruled. Yes, I have a clock in my car.
So you're positive the time that you left your driveway?
Yes, I am.
Okay, and you were wearing a white bow leather sweatshirt on the night of April 27, 1994, correct?
Right.
Okay, and you're an exceptional swimmer. You barely missed a spot in the U.S. Olympic team, correct?
Yes.
And you plan on trying in 88?
Yes.
Okay. Wouldn't these charges greatly affect your career? I mean, it could actually stop you from being on the Olympic team, correct?
Yes.
So, would you lie to protect yourself?
No.
Okay. You testified that Mr. Gabbardi was driving your car, isn't that correct?
Yes.
Did you know if Mr. Gabbardi had a driver's license?
No.
Did you ask?
Yes.
Come down.
Or no?
No, you did not ask.
No.
Okay, Ms. Ballard, is it a custom for you to let people who you know doesn't know have a driver's license, doesn't know the area and who's new to the country, whom you've known for less than half an hour, drive your car?
I understand the question.
You've known Mr. Gabbardi less than half an hour. You didn't know if he had a driver's license. He didn't know the area, Bellwether. Is it normal for you to let people drive you home under these conditions?
What you're asking.
Ask her one question at a time.
She needs to make the question more clear.
Okay, please rephrase the question so that she can understand.
Hold on.
Can I have a
20 seconds?
Just ask her one of those questions at a time. One at a time. Did you know that these are all those, like, yeah, because they should have rejected earlier. They should have called it a compound question. So you just ask her those questions one at a time. You're doing good. You're doing great.
Yes, she is. Order in the court.
So you were uncertain if Mr. Gabbardi had a driver's license, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And did you know if he knew the area of Bellwether very well?
No.
Okay, and you knew Mr. Gabbardi for less than half an hour, isn't that correct?
Yes.
Do you normally let people under these conditions drive you home?
No.
But you did with Mr. Gabbardi.
Yes.
You say Mr. Gabbardi dropped you off at home, isn't that correct?
Yes.
Did you get dropped off right after the accident?
Yes.
Did Mr. Gabbardi give your keys back to you?
Yes.
Couldn't you have used them? Couldn't you have driven back? Oh, wait, sorry, compound question. Couldn't you have used them?
Objection, question too vague.
Yeah.
Couldn't you have use them to drive back to the scene where Miss LaFrance was hit?
Yes.
Okay, could you please have the witness answer accordingly?
Please answer.
Why isn't you didn't drive or even walk back
to see if Miss LaFrance is okay.
Would you walk at 11:30 at night in a neighborhood, go back to someone? And I wasn't about to drive my car all the way back to the scene when I was upset, frightened, and scared. You're not supposed to be driving when you're in an emotional state like
okay.
that.
Okay. Would you please have her answer this?
Yes, yes. Well, counsel's questions would be yes or no answer.
Okay, Miss Officer Martinez was detained at the hospital for approximately an hour before he'd gone to Mrs. Franklin's and then reached your door. Why isn't it you didn't call the police? Okay, okay. You had an hour before he came to your door. Isn't that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, please, you please answer accordingly.
Please answer counsel's questions accordingly.
Could you tell us what were you doing for that hour between the time you got dropped off at home, Mr. Officer Martinez got to your door?
Oh, I was trying to relax. I went inside my house. I was frightened. I had no one to call. My parents weren't even home. So I was just walking. I was pacing back and forth in my house. I figured since Ralph is a medical student that he would have had already called the ambulance.
After he hit somebody and told you not to call the police, you assumed he would go ahead and call 911?
Yeah, I mean, being a medical student, would you care about someone laying in the middle of the road? Wouldn't
okay.
you at least call it anonymously?
Okay, could you please have her answer all my questions if you ask
her? Please ask her counsel's questions if you ask her no answer.
Ms. Ballard, you refused to take the alcohol level test when Officer Martinez first asked you, isn't that correct?
Yes.
Isn't it because you were afraid the test would be positive and would show that you were drunk, Ms. Ballard?
Objection, Your Honor, calls for opinion.
Sustained. Jury, please disregard the last question.
Okay, could you please ask her? Yes, answer accordingly.
Please answer questions accordingly.
Okay. Could you please tell us why it is that you first agreed to answer the officer's questions and then refused?
I agreed to answer all his questions. I never refused to not answer any of his questions. I answered all his questions willingly.
Can I approach the bench for a minute?
And you guys got to go up with this. Cover your mic. Hers.
Amanda's.
Amanda, cover your mic.
She took up on her rights.
She shouldn't be listening anyway.
Excuse me. You're supposed to say this low enough so that
the witness
doesn't
hear you. She's just like, let's drop that ear in.
Whisper, attorneys. Counsel, please whisper.
We're all getting all in your counsel.
You in the middle of your car. Okay.
You have a compact car, right?
Yes.
Okay. How many seats are in your car?
Two long seats.
Two long seats in a compact car?
Yeah. They're not bucket seats if that's what you're trying to get at.
Okay. And Mrs. Franklin's testimony, she said she saw one person and no disfigurements. You stated that you sat up abruptly when Miss Franklin, when you hit Mrs. LaFrance.
I didn't hit Mrs. LaFrance.
When your car struck Mrs. LaFrance, is that correct?
Yeah, I got up right when you hit her. I went up with that.
So then when Miss Franklin saw two figures, not one?
I don't know what Miss Franklin could have saw.
Objection, she has no knowledge.
Please,
Mr. Had you seen Mr. Porter drink at the party? Did Mr. Porter warn you at any time of the evening that he had seen Mr. Gavardi drinking?
No.
So you had no knowledge that Mr. Gavardi had been drinking that evening? That you had a few drinks that night. Isn't it possible that you could have missed the turn and have gone up and you would have crossed 22nd and Foothill Boulevard?
No, I've lived here 17 years. No matter what state I'm in, I think I know the way to my house.
I asked just yesterday.
Crazy. You didn't ask me. You gotta make it. You didn't say that. Because you asked me to report out the map. So if they're not that, I will come.
Wait, please instruct the witness to answer yes or no.
Please answer yes or no to all
counsel's questions. Having a few drinks, isn't it possible that you might have missed the turn and you could have crossed 22nd Foothill Boulevard?
No.
It's not possible even being drunk.
No.
Thank you for the question.
She wasn't drunk.
Do closing statements first, they do.
No, you go first.
He stated it already.
It says in the form, the prosecution goes first. Prosecution should start opening statement.
Prosecution always starts first.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we are ready.
Testimonies are true in fact, and some are just purely fiction. But that is not for me to decide. I'm not here to call anyone a liar. That, too, is for you to decide. Let's start with the testimony of Miss Franklin. Now, this woman witnessed the entire accident. She was not only able to see the driver, but she was also able to write down the license plate. Mind you, that she took this down before taking her medication. After taking her medication, she called Officer Martinez. She was also able to identify the witness by her profile and her long hair, not to mention the white sweatshirt. Ms. Franken stated that the young lady driving the car was wearing a white sweatshirt, not a dark jacket. Let me remind you that Ms. Franken took her medication after writing down the driver's license. Let me also remind you that Ms. Franken does not know Cindy Ballard well enough to want to convict her, nor does she know Ms. LaFrance well enough to lie to her. She is just a citizen doing her job. Now let's review Mr. Gabardi's testimony. A young Switzerland exchange student who just wanted to make a few friends and get a good education in the U.S. Little did he know that he'd be blamed for a tragic crime committed by Ms. Ballard. In Ms. Franklin's statement, it was approximately 11:30 at night when Ms. LaFrance was viciously struck down. But Mr. Gabardi, in his statement, was at home in time enough to hear the beginning monologue of Johnny Carson, which starts at about 11:30. So it is pretty much impossible for Mr. Gabardi to have struck down Ms. LaFrance unless he is able to be in two places at once, which defense has proven that has not been able to prove. Now let's review Mr. Jerry Porter's testimony. Now this is a very interesting testimony, I must say. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Porter says that he is not attracted to Ms. Ballard, yet he watched her every move from the time she came to the party to the time that she left. She was introduced to Ms. Gabardi in the time they left to her car. Now Mr. Porter says he saw Mr. Gabardi drink straight from a vodka bottle, but he also stated that he saw Mr. Gabardi get into the driver's seat of Ms. Ballard's car. Now Mr. Porter stated he went upstairs to watch a few empty videos and also to use the restroom. Now I ask you, how could Mr. Porter have seen Mr. Gabardi drink straight from a vodka bottle while upstairs watching videos? And wouldn't he be paying more attention to what he was doing in the restroom instead of watching Ms. Ballard outside? I think so. Mr. Porter has certainly got his fictionist story mixed up. And that leads me to Ms. Cindy Ballard's best friend, Ms. Jill Carver, whom wasn't sure of her testimony to begin with. There were so many times that she had contradicted herself. She contributed to the drinking of minors. Yes, there was liquor in her home, but she had the ability to take these people out. She said in her testimony that Ms. Ballard did not get drunk in her home, yet she also stated that she enjoyed seeing her best friend drunk. There is a contradiction right there in itself. Ms. Cochran isn't sure of any of her testimony, but we are positive, without a reasonable doubt, Ms. Cochran broke the law once before. So why would she break it again by lying for a best friend? Remind you, also, that she did not see Mr. Gabardi drive away in that car. Now let's review a person's testimony that is completely irrelevant to this case, Mrs. Narasaki. She did not witness the accident. She was not at the party, and she did not see anyone drinking. Her only importance to this case was to bail Ms. Ballard out of jail. Now let's discuss Ms. Ballard's testimony. I don't think she had enough time to rehearse her part, or she would have smoothed out the little kinks in her story, such as the fact that she would let a foreigner, whom she's only known for about 20 to 30 minutes, without a license, and who did not know the rules of bellwether, drive her home in her family car. My, as a female, I wouldn't let a man that I don't know drive my car drunk. She could have went into her home. She could have went back to her friend Jill Cochran's house and asked her if she could lie down or have her good friend Mr. Barry Porter drive her home. But instead, she asked someone who did not know the roads on a rainy night to drive her home. I didn't see it. Ms. Cochran asked for someone she could have went in there and asked for someone to lie down. I think she could have. And I'm sure with her being her best friend, she could have found accommodations for her friend to lie down, seeming that she was ill that day. But even her best friend, Jill Cochran, would have let a young man, and Mr. Porter would have let a man who he claimed to have seen drinking, drive a friend of his home drunk? I think not. I think, as a female, I would have been highly upset if Mr. Gabardi told me that he had a girlfriend, and I was coming on to him. He comes out of here and tells me, well, he has a girlfriend. I personally would have told him to get out of my car. I'll drive myself home. But she did not. She asked him to drive her home. And Mr. Gabbardi refused, because he did not want to upset her further. Defense's witness stated that Ballard is a caring, loving person, but yet she never went back to see if Mrs. Cramp was okay. And is it so hard to dial 911 within an hour? They don't take forever to pick up the phone. She could have stated that there was an accident, like she said. She could have made an anonymous phone call. She did not have to incriminate herself, seeing as that she was the driver of the car. Now, does that sound like a caring person to you? It sounds like a hidden blame to me. Now that the facts have been presented to you, I ask you to make the right decision. The Miss Sandy Ballard is guilty as charged of the crime committed. Because remember, next time it could be a defenseless child. It could be your mother. It could be your husband. It could even be you. So let's see that justice is done by putting Miss Sandy Ballard behind bars where she belongs. Thank you.
Order in the court. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, it is about your turn to make your decision on this case. But before you do, I am going to prove to you that the defendant, Miss Cindy Ballard, is not guilty beyond reasonable doubt. That Miss Ballard was not driving the Ballard automobile the night of the accident. That, in fact, it was Mr. Ralph Gabbardi. At this time, I would like to rename the case Cindy Ballard versus Ralph Gabbardi. And I will prove that there is no reason to disbelieve Miss Ballard's testimony, but every reason to disbelieve Mr. Ralph Gabbardi's. While I read my closing statement, I would like you to notice that the witness's testimony will be consistent with Cindy Ballard's, all but Ralph Gabbardi's. Cindy Ballard, she stated that she and Ralph left the party at 11:10, that they talked for 15 minutes, so that means that he got out of the car and she left the party out of the driveway onto the street at 11:25. With Ralph driving and Cindy in the passenger seat, they went down the slick, slippery roads, and Ralph struck the victim, Miss LaFrance. And he begged Cindy not to say anything about the accident. She asked him to go back, but he refused. And Cindy went to her house, confused, and Ralph walked home from her house. Jill Cochran, she saw Cindy and Ralph leave the party together. 15 minutes later, she saw the car pull out of the driveway. And Cindy was in the passenger seat. Barry Porter saw Cindy and Ralph also leave the party, and he witnessed Ralph Gabbardi drinking straight out of a vodka bottle. In direct examination, Ralph stated that his father was an alcoholic. In cross-examination, when I asked him if that is a hereditary trait, he denied it. Now, we all know that alcohol is a hereditary trait. So wouldn't that be likely for him to be drinking out of a vodka bottle? You will note that up to this point, no testimony or evidence is inconsistent with the defendant, Miss Cindy Ballard. Now the prosecution witnesses. Miss LaFrance. Miss LaFrance, she was jogging the night of April 27th, 1984. She was struck. She did not see the car. She did not see the driver. So therefore, the poor victim, although she was hurt, has no irrelevance in this case. She cannot determine who was driving the car. Miss Franklin. Now, this lady, she witnessed the accident on April 27th. We already stipulated that the Ballard automobile was an accident. Miss Franklin identified the license plate. She had less than a second to see this car, but yet she testified that she was able to see the license plate and the driver of the car. She must have a lot of eyes. But in Miss Franklin's statement to Officer Martinez, she states she could not identify the driver of the car. Yet in cross-examination, we asked her if she could identify the driver of the car. She said yes. Therefore, Miss Franklin really does not know what she actually saw. And so, therefore, we cannot believe her testimony now. Officer Martinez received a call about the accident. We went and questioned Ms. LaFrance at the hospital. He was there at 12:25. And then from there, he questioned Ms. Cindy Ballard and booked her at 2 o'clock. He states that she acted defensive when he questioned her. But wouldn't you be defensive if somebody came to your house, already concluded that you were guilty
and was questioning you, of course he's going to be defensive in his opinion. He was just trying to solicit a confession out of Miss Cindy Ballard. He testified that Rob's clothes were wet when he went to visit her. Rob walked home from Miss Ballard's house. That was why his clothes were wet. Officer Martinez believed that Cindy had been drunk. But we know that that is not true because the charges were dropped. She was not drunk. And this brings up a question. Why didn't Officer Martinez not test Ralph Gabbardi for drunk driving? Maybe because he did not think he was drinking, but yet he already concluded that Cindy had been drinking. Isn't an officer's job to check out every detailed investigation? He did not do his job if he did not check out his breath. Because he already concluded that Cindy was guilty. He didn't even want to really look into the details of Ralph Gabbardi. Therefore, he failed to do his real job. Now, Ralph Gabbardi. Ralph stated that he was home in time for the monologue of the Johnny Carson show at 11:30. Why is this time 11:30 so important? Because he would have you believe that he was not involved in the accident if he was home by 11:30, since the accident happened at 11:30. Ralph stated that he was talking to Cindy 15 minutes before she left the party. Cindy left the party at 12:25. And we know that from Jill Cochran's house to Ralph's apartment, it is at least a mile. So he is to believe that within from 12:25 to 11:30, which is 5 minutes, he was able to walk a mile, change his clothes, dry off, in time for the monologue? That is impossible. Nobody could have done that in 5 minutes. Now that the jury is quite impossible, we can now see that Ralph is lying. Another way to prove to you is that if Cindy were driving, she already stated that she would have drove this direction. She would have came this way. Did not even reach the path that Miss LaFrance was hit. But if Ralph was driving, of course, he would have drove this way, the crosswalk Miss LaFrance was hit. He would have passed that, and he would have hit Miss LaFrance. She has lived in that area for so long, she would not have just because she was feeling a bit ill and drove that way. It's naturally habit to drive the way she always does. That's her best friend. She goes to her house all the time. She knows those roads by the back of her hand. And the last way I will prove to you that he is guilty is that Ralph stated Officer Martinez questioned him at 12:30. We know that Officer Martinez questioned Miss LaFrance at 12:25. He did not get to Cindy's house and book here till 2:20 a.m. From there, he went to go see and question Mr. Ralph Gabbardi. How could he have been at Ralph's house at 12:30? Ralph Gabbardi is lying. Ralph Gabbardi is the guilty one of this crime. He lies in all aspects. I've proven to you beyond reasonable doubt that she is not guilty. Thank you for your attention.
Order in the court. Jury, you have heard the facts presented in the order in the court. Jury, you have heard the facts presented in this case, and now it is time for you to make your decision. Miss Cindy Ballard has been charged with felony hit and run under California Vehicle Code 2001 and 203. Felony hit and run is described as failure to stop at the scene of an accident in which he or she is involved and failing to give aid to anyone who might be injured in the accident. There are two decisions in which we ask you to make. First, you must determine if the accused is guilty of hit and run beyond a reasonable doubt. If you feel that there is sufficient evidence to justify finding of guilt by the defendant for the hit and run of Genevieve LaFrance, then return a verdict of guilty. However, if you feel that based on the facts presented to you, there is a reasonable doubt that the defendant is guilty of the charge brought against her, then return a verdict of not guilty. You must be unanimous in your decision. Secondly, you must decide which team of lawyers did the best job in presenting their case in this trial. You need to obtain merely a majority vote in reaching this decision. Do you have any questions?
I don't know.
go now and have your discussions, and when you have reached your decision, report them to the court.
Go get your stuff.
Amanda. That's just another way
Amanda.
Of saying.
Amanda.
Go get your stuff in your
after
car.
They, after they leave, tell them that the court is in recess until they get back.
Okay, court is dismissed.
You're not guilty.